today we can discuss about so we can test some of the problems is there. See, in first question, in a population which is in a Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, 512 individuals out of 3200. Now the total population is what? 3200. Out of 3200, 512 peoples are roll tongue. It is a recessive to the normal tongue. That's why now I can consider as a, it is a recessive. That's why they gave recessive, that is what? Q square they gave. Find out the heterozygous individuals in that population. We can find 2PQ. Is there or not? Now here, when you calculated the total number of individuals, first we need a frequency. The first step is Q square equals to 512 by 3200. Now 3200 512. Now I can keep point like this. You will get a ones are 3200. Now you can get a 0, 2, 3200, 4200. We will get a 1920. We will get a. Now for calculations, 3200 into 6, I think 6 zero, 6 zero, 6 is 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, 19. That's why you can get a 6. That's why, see, Q square equal to 0.16. Q equal to root of 0.16, you can get a 0.4. That's why P plus Q equals to 1. Now P equals to 1 minus 0.4, you can get a 0.6. That's why, see, 2PQ, 2 into, we can keep 0.6 into 0.4. 0.48 into 3200. Now approximately they can get a 16, 8 3s are 24, 25, 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12, 6, 8 9 10, 13, 5, 15, 36. The answer is what? 15, 36. You can calculate it like this. The second problem, in a population 136 out of 200 individuals are homozygous dominant. It means they give what? P square. Find out the dominant allelical frequency. They can ask the frequency. That's why you can calculate the frequency means 136 by 200. Now 200, 136, 200, 6 are 1200, 160 point already is there, 8. That's why you can get water. Is the answer. The next one, the third problem is, in a Hardy-Weinberg population of Drosophila, gray color body is dominant over ebony and the total population is 1300. If the allelical frequency of recessive trait is 0.8. Q they can give, that is 0.8. Find out the total number of gray color organisms in that population. See, now it means they can give what? Q. P plus Q equals to 1. Now P equals to 1 minus 0.8. You can get what? 0.2. They can ask what? Number of individuals of dominant one. That's why here we know the P. Now I need a P square. That's why 0.2 into 0.2, you can get 0.04. That's why they can ask individual means into total number of individuals. That is what? 1300. You can get a 52. That's why the number of individuals is how much? 52. Now, the fourth question. In a population of 278, if observed, the number of MM, MN and NN blood groups are 78, 138 and 62. This is MM, MN, NN. And they can ask what? Frequency of M. Frequency of M. I already said they having a formula. If they can guess the number of individuals, if can calculate the frequency, they having a formula, that is what? 2 into, if they can ask M indicates what? Dominant one. Number of dominant individuals plus heterozygous individuals by 2 into total number of individuals. If you calculate a compression, you can get the answer according to the frequency. And then remaining the questions is also always, see, in a population of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, fifth question, among that 250 organisms, it means the total number of individuals is how much? 250. In that, homozygous dominant and recessive organisms, in the percentage they can give 20%. 20% is the homozygous dominant and 30% is the recessive one. Now, can you say 20% means, can you say number of individuals is 50? Why? Because out of 250, you can take it as 100%. 10% is 25, 20% is the 50. And if you go for the recessive, 30% means how much individuals? 75. Now, they can ask the question, the allelical frequency of recessive trait, simply you can calculate it, 75 by 250, you can get the answer. Now, the remaining problems is same as that what we can discuss about the 5 problems. Today, we can discuss about mutation. What is differentiation between the mutation and evolution means? Mutation is a gradual process, but mutation is sudden, random, inheritable changes takes place in the organism is known as a mutation. But evolution is a gradual continuous process and can form a new speciation. Here, if they can ask, formation of new species, the raw material is obtained from mutation? Yes, the raw materials is obtained from the mutation. The term mutation is coined by Hugo de Vries, coined the term mutation. Here, what is it? Mutation is in a sudden random process. In this, see, he can observe Oenothera lamarckiana. In this, Oenothera lamarckiana is commonly called as a evening primrose plant. In this evening primrose plant only, he can observe 4 different types of forms. One is the Oenothera brevis style. Brevis style indicates that the style is small, style is there. And then you can observe Oenothera levolfia, it will be indicates smooth leaves are present, smooth leaves. And then Oenothera gigas, it means the plant is very tall. Nanella dwarf plant, one is the giant plant, another one is the dwarf plant. That's why in the same species only he can observe different types of forms due to the mutation. And then T.H. Morgan, he can observe the mutation characters in the Drosophila. Here, what are the silent features of the mutation? The silent features in nature, mutation is occur time to time. Mutation is occur time to time. I always said it is the raw material. And then, see, mutation is in a single step. Single step. It means from one species, a new species is formed. Between that, there is no intermediate steps. There is no intermediate steps. That type of process is called as a mutation process. Now, the next one is the speciation. See, the next one is the speciation. What is meant by speciation means? The process by which a species can evolve into two or more different species, is known as a speciation. That's why, what is speciation? It is a process. One species can be evolved into the two or different species, that is called as a speciation. In that, first we can go for the anagenesis. Anagenesis, cladogenesis. See, anagenesis means a species with a single lineage, they can form a new species. A species with a single lineage, they can form a one new species, that is called as a anagenesis. Cladogenesis means a species they can form two different types of species, that is called as a cladogenesis. Now I can say an example. Suppose, according to the anagenesis, I can go for the giraffe. Giraffe. The giraffe, first the organism having a short neck. Now it is the organism I can name as a. This A, they can form a B. Now, A organism is extincted. B, they can form a C. Now, B is extinct. Now, C is present. Now, C is a long neck one. This is the short neck, intermediate neck, long neck. That's why, with a single lineage only, they can form a only one type of speciation, that is called as a anagenesis. Now, this organism is not there. Now, suppose if you observe the cladogenesis, this is a species. This species, they can form a two different species. Now, it is the origin of organism for okapi and giraffe. What is differentiation between the okapi and giraffe means? Okapi is in a forest zebra. Okapi is in a forest zebra. This is the long neck. Here there is no long neck. But these two organisms, the original species is this one. This is the original species. That's why this original species, they can form a two different types of species, that is called as a cladogenesis. And then allopatrical speciation. And sympatric speciation. Allopatrical speciation means a new species is formed due to the geographical isolation. It means now this is a original population. In this original population, one species is isolated, enter into the new geographical area, and they can form a new species that is called as a allopatrical speciation. Sympatrical speciation means the same species enter into the different geographical area of the same habitat. They can form two or more different species. That is called as a sympatrical speciation. Here, not a same habitat, but here they having a same habitat. They can form a two or different species, but they not able to interbreed. That type of speciation is called as a sympatrical speciation.